Hello students, welcome back to maths class. Today we are going to study chapter number 5, fractions. So, fractions, here is an image for you. Are you all excited after seeing this image? No need to dance. Okay. So, here there is a chocolate and a pizza. Suppose you are having one chocolate with you and you have to share it among four of your friends. Then how you will share? You will share it into four pieces. You will divide it into four pieces, right? So your fraction is 1/4. Same way, if you are having one pizza with you and that you want to divide it among eight of your friends, then 1/8. So in this way, the fraction is useful in our real life. Now, for the same example, if you want to divide one pizza among two, then it will be 1/2. Similarly, here all the images are given. If you want to divide one pizza among 10 persons, then you will divide it into 1/10, right? So here, you must be thinking that what this image is useful for. In your exams, you will be given some kind of images like this and you have to take out the fraction from it. So how you will make out the fraction from the given image? Here you can see there are partitions, right? Let us take example of this 1/6. If you will count, total there are 6 partitions. Among that, one is shaded. So it is 1/6. Suppose if two are shaded here, then it will be 2/6. Similarly, here if you will see, there are 9 divisions and one is shaded, so it will be 1/9. So this way you are going to write out fractions from the images. Now, how you will represent fraction on a number line? Number line you have already studied in previous chapters. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that you used to write. So in a number line, suppose if you want to write half, 1/2 if you want to write, then you know that it will come between 0 and 1. So here 0/2 means 0 and 2/2 means 1. So it will come exactly between 0 and 1. Similarly, if you want to write 3/4, so you will see the denominator. Here the denominator is 4. So you will divide the line into 4 parts, 4 equal parts. So 0 and 1, in between that you are going to make 4 parts. And here 3/4 will come after 3 parts. Okay. Similarly, here you can see 2/2 is coming. Suppose you have to mark 6/2 in your number line. So 6/2 is 3. Then if you want to mark 7/2, then how you will mark? 7/2 will come between 3 and 4. How? If you will convert this 7/2, it will be 3.5. So it will come between 3 and 4. Okay. So this you have to keep it in mind. Whatever divisions are given, it should be coming in on number line like this. Okay, you have to decide where it will come. Now, next topic is equivalent fraction. Here you can see there are 4 images. All the 4 images are same. How you can say? All the 4 images are same because it is equivalent fraction. Now, what is equivalent fraction? Equivalent fraction means equal. So it is not like that 1/2 is not equal to 2/4, is equal to 3/6. So if you are going to see, there is one circle. In that circle, the shaded parts are half only. If there are 8 parts, then 4 parts if you are having means it is half. If there are 6 parts, out of that 3 parts you are having means it is half. So all these 4 images are half. So we can say it is equivalent fraction. Now, how you can form equivalent fraction? In your exercise, it is given that you have to convert the given fraction into equivalent fractions, or you have to form three equivalent fractions. So for forming the equivalent fractions, we are going to multiply the fraction with same number. See, 1 upon 2 is there, you will multiply it with 2, you will divide it with 2. So 1 2s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. Similarly, if you will multiply the same number by 2 upon 2 or 3 upon 3, again you will get another equivalent fraction. So what we are doing here, we are multiplying and dividing with the same number, then we are getting equivalent fraction. Here you can use any number, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, any number you can use. But the thing is that the number which you are using on numerator, the same number should come in denominator. Clear? So this way you are going to form equivalent fraction. This all fractions are equivalent fractions. Now, how you will check that whether the given fraction is equivalent fraction or not? In your exam, you will be given two fractions, and if you have to tell that it is equivalent fraction or not, then what you will do? 4 upon 8 and 8 upon 16. So what you are going to do, you will cross multiply it. So 4 multiply 16, 8 multiply 8. So 4 multiply 16, you will get 64. 8 multiply 8, you will get 64. So if you are cross multiplying it, if you are getting the same number, means it is equivalent fraction. So if you want to check whether the fraction is equivalent or not, what you are going to do? You will cross multiply it. And if the answer is same, means it is equivalent fraction. Then the next topic is simplest form of a fraction. If you want to convert any fraction into its simplest form, then you are going to cut it. So how you will cut? Say for example, 3 upon 3. So 3, 3 gets cut, 1 remains. 3 upon 6. So 3 into 1 and 3 into 2. 3, 3 cut, again 1 upon 2 remains. Similarly, if 12 upon 18 is there, so 12 you know it is 6 2s are, 18 you know it is 6 3s are. So 6 6 got cut, what remains? 2 upon 3. So this is called the simplest form of a fraction. Simplest form of a fraction means it is the reduced form of a fraction. From that, you cannot reduce it further. They are not having any common factors now that you can cut it. Okay. So a fraction is in its simplest form when its numerator and denominator have no common factors other than 1. And to reduce a fraction to its simplest form, you have to divide the numerator and the denominator by their HCF. Means you have to find out the factors, then you cut the factors, common factors, and you will get the simplest form. Now, there are different type of fraction, different types of fractions. Proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fractions. So here, proper fraction means when the numerator is smaller than denominator, then it is called proper fraction. If the numerator is larger than denominator, then it is improper fraction. While mixed fraction means a whole number and a fraction. Now suppose if you want to divide a chocolate, and if you want to tell that whether it is a proper fraction or improper fraction or a mixed fraction, how you will tell? So suppose you are having 5 chocolates with you, and if you are going to divide it among 6 persons, means one piece will remain unshared, right? This 5 pieces you will be getting 1-1. So this is a proper fraction. Now 8 upon 6. If you will convert it, you will get 1 integer 2 upon 3. Means if you are having 8 chocolates and if you want to divide it among only 6 persons, so each person will get 1 chocolate and second part of the remaining chocolate like given in the picture. Okay, clear? So how we are going to convert improper fraction into mixed fraction? It is very simple. You will be dividing the number. 7 upon 2 is improper fraction. So you will divide 7 by 3. 2 will be your quotient. So what will happen? Your result will be, so 2 is your answer, so 2 integer, 1 is your remainder, so 1 will be your numerator. And always keep in your mind, denominator will remain same. So 2 integer 1 upon 3. This way we are going to convert. Next is how you will convert mixed fraction to improper fraction. That is also very easy. This you all have studied in the previous classes also. 5 integer 2 upon 3. So here what we are doing, we are multiplying this 3 by 5, and whatever answer we are getting, 3 into 5 we got 15, so 15 plus 2, whatever there it is here in numerator, that you will add and you will get your numerator and denominator will remain same. Okay. So your answer will be 5 multiply 3, 15 plus 2, 17 upon 3. Now the next topic and the last topic is like fraction and unlike fraction. So here the like fractions means when the denominator is same, then it is called like fractions. And if you are having the different denominators, then it is unlike fraction. Here are the examples, 1 upon 4, 2 upon 4, 3 upon 4. They are having same denominator, so it is a like fraction. And if the denominators are different, like 1 upon 2, 2 upon 3, 3 upon 4, means it is unlike fraction. Now, in the next video, we will be understanding the addition and subtraction of the fractions. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.